nowadays React has become the de facto standard for UI development. I see that not only US companies are preferring React, but every other country also is preferring React developers. So previously in India, at least, I used to see there was a huge demand for Angular. But if you see recent job posting, you can clearly see that there is a huge upward trend in React-based jobs compared to Angular.
If you are looking for a quick revision of the important concepts before you sit for the next React.js interview, your savior is here. Hello and welcome to DevTalks, a brand new series where we take a cursory glance of the basic concepts of skill sets and technologies that top American companies look for when hiring software engineers. If you're a back-end developer who'd like to switch to front-end development, or if you're a mobile developer who'd like to learn React, look no further. We are going to talk about all of this in this video. For the first chapter, we have with us Sivaprasad, who is hailing from Hyderabad, India. He is a full-stack developer at Turing, and he's skilled in a plethora of technologies like React, Node.js, Angular, and today we'll hear him talk about React.js, its components, alternative frameworks, and a few prerequisites that you must keep in mind before you open that React book. Let's get started. Hi, Siva. Thank you so much for sparing time for this discussion. How are you? And I'm sure you'd be having a pretty hectic schedule. How is it going?
Hey, Rina. Good evening. Thanks. I'm doing good. Thanks. This is a pretty hectic day today. So we are working on some high priority defects today. Hopefully, we will be completing them today.
Yeah. Interesting. I'm good as well. Thank you so much for asking, Siva. And before I forget to mention, the Siva that you see here on your screens today is pretty enthusiastic about online gaming. So what have you been trying your hands on lately?
So yeah, I'm pretty enthusiastic about both offline and online gaming as well. So I've been playing Horizon Zero Dawn right now. And online, I've been playing Apex Legends and Rocket League. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Any suggestions for the audience here?
Yeah, I mean, as I said, I prefer battle royale games, so Apex Legends is quite a good game.
Okay. This definitely sounds interesting, even though I'm not into online gaming. Okay, let us now talk about you, Siva. I believe you'd have tons of expert tips to share with our audience today. But before we get into that, tell us a little bit about yourself.
So yeah, I'm Shiva. I have nearly 8 years of experience in software development. So I hail from Hyderabad. I did my bachelor's in computer science in Shakapatnam, a very good city. You have to visit someday. So I started my career in TCS. I campus placed over there. So I started with technologies from my beginning of the career. So I have worked in a very prominent bank over there in TCS. After that, I moved to AT&T. And then I worked on React over there and started a bit on Node.js over there. So after that, I moved to EA, where I've been working on AWS technologies, React, Node.js, everything. So after that, finally, I moved to Turing.
Okay. How are you liking your work at Turing?
Yeah, it's really great. I really enjoy working. It's to be remote, right? It gives me a lot of freedom. It's very good.
I think it's very true what they say now. The future of work is boundaryless.
Yes, I completely agree with that.
Okay, let us now dive deep into the conversation that we're here for. Right. So React.js is amongst the most popular libraries of JavaScript. But before a developer opens the book, are there any prerequisites for learning React?
So yeah, React is completely a purely JavaScript-based library. So JavaScript is, I think, a preliminary requirement for React, learning React. So if you want to learn JavaScript, I think MDN would be a pretty good resource. I learned from that, so I suggest everyone to go through MDN and learn JavaScript basics before moving on to React.
Okay, sounds good. So would that mean that the shift from JavaScript libraries to React is comparatively easier?
Yes, yeah, absolutely. As I said, JavaScript is, React is built on JavaScript. You don't need to learn any new things to learn React. So compared to Angular, where you need to learn a lot of things before jumping into Angular, React is pretty straightforward. So if you have a good background on JavaScript, it's fairly easy to learn.
Okay. So aspiring developers, we have the first good news of the evening. If you're skilled in any one JavaScript library, you can try your hands at React and get matched with elite US companies with Turing today. Coming back to you, Siva, with all the hype that you think that revolves around this one JavaScript library, what do you think makes React unique? And how is it different from all other web frameworks?
Yeah, React, I believe, has a lot of positive points. Like, it has a very easy learning curve. It has a huge developer community and it has powerful features. So, and it, more importantly, it's back to test. And moreover, you don't need to have any extra, you don't need to learn huge things to go to learn React. It's if you know, standard JavaScript, that would be enough. So it attacks existing JavaScript developers a lot. So, and moreover, React can is not only a web development framework. You can use it to extend it to other environments as well. So, for example, using React Native, you can use it to mobiles, and using Electron React, you can extend it to desktop. So, I say that not only so React is mainly used for client side development, but it's you can with React you can go for server side rendering and static side generation using Next.js. So all in all, I think React encompasses all the it takes care of all the requirements that we might have while developing the web app or mobile app or desktop.
Okay, I think the fact that React is backed by Facebook definitely makes for the fact that it must have its own fan base.
Yeah, even I'm one of those.
Okay, sounds good. Sounds interesting. In fact, we know that most American firms look for engineers that are skilled in React.js. Why do you think, Siva, that is the case? Why do Silicon Valley companies look for a React as a skill set much more than all the other JavaScript libraries?
Yeah, I mean, this may be pretty subjective, but based on what I observed nowadays, React has become the de facto standard library for UI development. I see that not only US companies are preferring React, but every other country also is preferring React developers. So previously in India, at least, I used to see there was a huge demand for Angular. But if you see recent job posting, you can clearly see that there is a huge upward trend in React-based jobs compared to Angular. So in my opinion, this is due to easier learning curve for the React rather than the very huge development compared to Angular. You can see it in GitHub stats, downloads. You can clearly see that React is beating Angular very much. So even though Vue nowadays is catching up in personal preferences, I think it's quite less used in industry. So as per recent trends, based on what I observed, there are a lot more job opportunities for React developers compared to Angular also. So if anyone's intention is to get a good job in the US or for that matter of fact, any other campus, I think learning React would be a very good.
Okay. And to add to Siva's point, I'd like to quote an internal data here. That is, in the last 6 months, Turing jobs have predominantly been governed by React and Node.js. So if you're skilled in React and are looking for top American jobs, I think it is time to head on to Turing.com/jobs today.
Great to hear.
Okay. Now, Siva, even though we know that React has quite some popularity amongst top US companies, are there any alternative frameworks or libraries that you would suggest? What would you suggest if the option of React somehow disappears one fine day?
Yeah, I mean, there are a lot more alternatives to React. So, for example, for UI, Angular is a very good contender and use, and it has its inbuilt routing, and it's a complete ecosystem, and it has a very good community support as well. But I believe it has, you know, a bit steeper curve compared to React or Vue. Vue is a bit newer framework compared to Angular and React, but it has got a huge popularity within a short period of time. So for, I mean, for other, you know, JavaScript libraries not related to UI, I think for mobile development, previously we used to use React Native, but we have recently moved to Flutter pieces. And we are using TypeScript. It's pretty good. In fact, we have converted most of our code bases to TypeScript. And for backend, we are using Nest.js. This is, it's a framework on top of Node. So it is a pretty good framework to start backend development on. So for desktop, as I said, you can use Electron React, but if you don't want to use React, you can go ahead with Electron directly. So yeah, these are the ones that I remember on top of my head.
Okay, good to know that we have options, Siva. But would you say that it is a wise option for all aspiring developers to maybe be skilled in React first and then look at other JavaScript libraries?
Absolutely. So as I said, React has very, you know, easier learning curve. So you can start with React and, you know, use that. And if you don't like that, since it is all, it has already provided you a base for learning web technologies, you can move to other libraries. So I think, yeah, it would be a very wise option to start with React because currently, at least, there are huge job opportunities for React. So,
Okay, sounds good. Let us now talk about React components, Siva. So we know that there are several such components available for faster and easier web development. If you have to suggest a few of those to our audience here today, what would you say?
This depends on the project you're working, but there are several libraries that makes your development easier. For example, to maintain state, I think you have to use Redux. As your application grows, relying on React itself would be not that optimal. So you have to use Redux. And for dealing with forms, I would suggest, React Final Form if you have a lot of forms. And for if you have huge grids, I would suggest to use React Table. Similarly, for if you want to use internet scrolling, I would suggest to use React Window. And I mean, if you want to start with UI components, I think you can start with what we call, we have Bootstrap, React Bootstrap. But in our projects, we are using Yarn Design, so I would suggest that as well.
Okay, sounds fascinating. But I'm sure that there'd be a lot of challenges also that you would be facing while using React. So if you have to draw comparisons between strengths and weaknesses of React, in other words, if you have to do a SWOT analysis, what would your analysis say?
Actually, in my opinion, React has a lot more strengths compared to its weakness. Let's start with strengths because there are a lot more. I would suggest, as I was saying, React is easier to learn. It has very good resources and a lot of third-party libraries for web development. If you write correctly, it provides very good performance using virtual ROM. Can be used, can be extended to work in multiple environments like mobile, desktop, and other things. If you feel that client-side rendering is not your cup of tea and you want to go with server-side rendering or static site, you can use Next.js using React. So, and finally, it has a huge community support. So all in all, I think these are very good strengths of the React. And if we see weaknesses, as I said, I personally don't see that many weaknesses in React, but if I had to say some, so React is just a library. It only covers the view part of the UI. Doesn't provide inbuilt solutions that are required for most of the common scenarios. For example, routing is a pretty common scenario that we need to use in web applications. You have to use a third-party library, React Router, for that. State management. There are a lot many state management options available, Redux, Nobex, Recoil, those kind of things. So React does not provide inbuiltly these kind of options. You have to work on find a third-party library for that. So another thing which in my opinion, is not a weakness, but many people feel that. Many people have polarizing opinions. So React uses JSX, which is similar to HTML inside the JavaScript. So not many people like writing HTML in JavaScript. So I like it. I prefer that, but not many people prefer that. If I have to say one more thing, I think that using of React does not provide called a shadow DOM. So whatever the CSS you write, it might leak to other components if you are not there. So generally, we alleviate that problem using style components. But it would be a good idea. It could have been better if React has provided it in built. So yeah, these are the things I feel, weaknesses of React.
This was quite an elaborate analysis. And I'm sure this does give a lot of great insights to all aspiring developers who are listening to us right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, this was a super exciting session, Siva. But before we bring this discussion to a close, I would like you to suggest a few React resources or tutorials that would help budding web developers excel in this field.
In my opinion, the initial React tutorial is a very good starting point. Previously, not many people like to start with React tutorial, but it has improved a lot these days, and because of most of the things that are required to start with. The next step, I think, would be, as I said, would be learn third-party tools that we require for React, like, Redux or React Router and other such important tools. So I would also suggest, getting a lot of hands-on and knowledge on JavaScript, because as I said, JavaScript is the base for React. So in my opinion, as I said earlier, MDN would be a very good resource. And recently I tried good by javascript.info. It also is a very good resource for JavaScript.
Okay. Thank you so much for sharing all of these details with us. This was great. And thanks again for being a part of a global community of extremely skilled developers and engineers. We hope that this video reaches the larger developer community and helps us give many such great opportunities to skilled developers like you from across the globe. To everybody listening, we'd be happy to answer any and every question that you would have. Please feel free to drop us an email at support@turing.com. Also, let us know in the comments below who we should host on a panel in the next video. Give us a big fat thumbs up if you like this video, and do not forget to subscribe to Turing.com. We will be back with many more such Turing developer stories. Till then, stay safe and click on the link in the description below to apply to Turing.